The role of the Vietnamese struggle for liberation held center stage during this historical period. Robert and Mabel broadcast many commentaries about Vietnam on Radio Free Dixie, and later anti-war broadcasts beamed from Hanoi to U.S. soldiers. In 1968, from China, Williams wrote and distributed Listen, Brother, an anti-war pamphlet addressed to black soldiers fighting in Vietnam. Robert and Mabel also visited Vietnam, participating in an international solidarity conference.
It is a crying shame that hypocritical and double-dealing Mr. Charlie has the audacity to rabble-rouse racist America to the point of accepting massive violence against the innocent people of Vietnam while brainwashing the oppressed Negro to adhere to the masochistic philosophy of nonviolence. Yes, Big Daddy orders a semi-state of war footing and dispatches elite troops to defend Mr. Charlie's version of democracy in Vietnam, while Afro-Americans bleed and die from the lack of police protection in the black ghettos of racist America. What a sham! What blatant hypocrisy! Black Americans can be unjustly imprisoned, maimed, and murdered without recourse to law in the social jungle of racist America. Yet black men are expected to fight and die in a white man's war of conquest and imperialism. What is this so-called democracy that miserable poor whites and oppressed and dehumanized blacks are ordered to fight and die for? It is a phony democracy where police brutality is considered standard procedure. It is a farce of a democracy where the worth of an individual is determined by the color of one's skin. It is Greensboro, Alabama, where defenseless women and children are being gassed, clubbed, maimed, and jailed for seeking human rights in a savage country that has assigned unto itself the Hitlerite task of introducing white supremacy, law, and order to a multicolored world.
We had gone to Vietnam prior to our final move to China. There was a peace conference that took place in Hanoi. And Rob and I went to Hanoi and participated in the conference in support of the Vietnamese people in their fight against the United States. We met Ho Chi Minh. We met one young man who had been napalmed by our American troops. We met with a pilot who had been shot down over Vietnam. They brought him to have an evening with us. The Vietnamese brought him.
We were guests of Ho Chi Minh, and when we left, started to leave from China, Peking, the Vietnamese embassy invited us for dinner. And so when we got ready to go, they gave us some presents, and they stood up, and the man said, we want to thank you, and we want to congratulate you. And I asked him, why do you want to thank me? He said, because we read your publication. He said, and we were fighting the battle limited to the countryside. And we read your publication on urban guerrilla warfare, and we realized we had to go into the city. And that's where the idea came from. And when we looked at your people in the city of Detroit, what they had done to it, we decided to have the Tet Offensive. So don't ever think that what you're doing is not being seen.